subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with India that has been successful thus far at battling COVID-19. It is one of the few countries that have really flattened the curve. While the number of cases touched a million in the United States and at least 100,000 in different European countries, India has been able to stem the spread. There are 25,000 cases in the country, with almost all of them showing mild symptoms. Agencies and people, including Bill Gates, have lauded the commitment of Indian leadership.
India's comprehensive steps at containing the spread of coronavirus have been successful at yielding positive results. While India's doubling rate has slowed down in past 2 weeks, more tests with more measures are winning it the first round of the battle against COVID-19. It is also working at war footing in acquiring more kits, more PPEs and other sophisticated equipments to stem the spread. India is not only developing everyday multi-pronged strategies to challenge the pandemic, but is also supporting its neighbours and allies that are dependent on it. Recently, it sent 23,000 kilograms of medicinal supply to neighbouring Nepal as a goodwill gesture to help the Himalayan nation fight COVID-19.
ये औषधि मैं मानता हूँ कि हमारे देशों के सहयोग का एक उदाहरण है और कोविड-19 को लड़ने के लिए जितना भी हम देशों ने अकेले किया आपस में मिलके किया दूसरों देशों के साथ मिलके किया वो पूरी श्रृंखला की एक ये एक कड़ी है एक चरण है
It is not only those who have received an aid have lauded Indian efforts, but neutral and renowned personalities and agencies too have hailed Indian endeavours at fighting the virus. Co-founder of Microsoft, Bill Gates, has written to PM Narendra Modi, praising his leadership in dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic. He said, and I quote, "Grateful to see that you are seeking to balance public health imperatives with the need to ensure adequate social protection for all Indians." Morning Consult Agency, a data research company from the United States, in its research has claimed that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is number one in dealing with the COVID-19 outbreak, while US President is on number eight. He has been given -3 points by this agency. The World Health Organization too have acknowledged the work done by India. The smallest state of the country and a major tourist hub, Goa was the first to be declared coronavirus free as it had not reported any new case since April 3rd and the last of the 7 patients in the state recovered.
After the 3rd April, एक भी पॉजिटिव केस नहीं मिली है और लास्ट पेशेंट जो था वो आज नेगेटिव आ गया है मुझे अनाउंस करते वक्त कि गोवा में एक भी इस वक्त पॉजिटिव पेशेंट नहीं है बहुत खुशी की बात है
हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया सेड दैट अपार्ट फ्रॉम गोवा a total of 59 districts in the country have not reported any new case of coronavirus in the last 14 days. A spanner in Indian Works, however, came from China, whose thousands of antibody kits were found to be inefficient or totally spurious in some cases. Now, the Indian Council of Medical Research has started analyzing results from the evaluation of antibody test kits imported from China and will come out with its conclusions on their efficacy early next week. The government says it will return all the faulty equipment. China has received flags from several other countries for supplying a completely waste material, both in cases of aid or business. Meanwhile, economic activities partially resumed in some parts of India. Government offices also began their work with 50% of the workforce in many Indian cities. Vehicles were being sanitized and employees also underwent thermal screening at the Parliament House.
Moving on to war torn Afghanistan, where in a unique way of fighting coronavirus, food truck owners have converted their trucks into disinfectant vehicles and they are now assisting the government by disinfecting roads and other places. The country has a weak health system and requires a robust technique to fight the disease, but a growing people participation has definitely provided a shot in their arm. A report.
Afghan food vendor Marzia Sikandar is dressed head to toe in a personal protective suit as she drives her food cart down the street. But instead of dishing out burgers like she used to, she is now providing hand washing services, spraying people with disinfectant and handing out face masks. These solar-powered carts from Bannos Kitchen, meaning Ladies Kitchen in Dari, have been converted into disinfection vehicles in a bid to stop the spread of coronavirus in Kabul by boosting public hygiene.
دای رکشا گفتای خوب مواد دیشوی داریم مواد دیدکونی داریم ماکس داریم 60 70 تا ماکس در روز توزیع میکنیم از خداوند چی هستم که می مرض به خیر سر ما بو ام تو کورده به خیر بو بره دیگه از مردم هم خواهش میکنم که مسافه و چی در مراوات کنه که پر سیاد خاتم و سیاد کل هموطنای ما سر از مشکل خلق نکنه برای مردم
From 50 women running 25 food carts in Kabul previously, according to Bannos Kitchen, there are now 40 carts travelling throughout the city run by 80 women and men at the forefront of fighting COVID-19. The government provided the funds to convert the food carts into these mobile disinfectant vehicles and is also funding the purchase of their disinfectant supplies, face masks and workers' salaries.
خود 100% نگران هستیم به خاطر از اینکه مردم باید فاصله را مراعات کنند بین یک و نیم متر دور استاد شود از ما هم از این خاطر مردم ها را زیاد چی میکنیم که از ما فاصله بگیره یا خودشان در بین خودن فاصله ایجاد کند تا بین دست خدا نبوشوین و زیده وفونیشان کنیم که خدا نخواسته در این مرض مبتلا نشن
If and when the coronavirus pandemic comes to an end, Bannos Kitchen said they will convert these carts, which are solar powered and considered zero carbon, back to food carts for their women vendors to sell local delicacies again.
I came up with an idea that why don't we convert our zero carbon food carts into mobile, solar powered, disinfecting and sanitizing carts. So that was an idea I came up with and the organizations which sponsored us was the Administrative Office of the President and the National Procurement Authority. So they help us financially so that we can buy disinfecting liquid, also so that we can convert these zero carbon food carts into mobile disinfecting and sanitizing carts. And also they are providing us the salaries for the staff.
Afghanistan's fragile healthcare system, creaking under the strain of extreme poverty and decades of war, lacks the capacity to adequately test or track cases. As of 24th April, the country had conducted only a little over 6,000 tests. Afghanistan reported a total of 1,279 cases of coronavirus, with 42 deaths according to Health Ministry figures.
Moving on, the stronghold of Islamic fundamentalists in Pakistan is making the country's battle with COVID-19 extremely difficult. Though the country had called for a nationwide lockdown, but it gave in to clerics' demand that mosques be allowed to stay open during the Islamic holy month of Ramadan. Government's decision is strongly criticized by the country's doctors, who are urging to reimpose the mosque restriction, as otherwise the coronavirus spread could go out of control. Have a look.
Leading Pakistani doctors recently convened a news conference where they urged the government and clerics to reverse a decision to allow prayer congregations at mosques during the Muslim holy month of Ramadan, warning that the spread of coronavirus could spiral out of control. Though the Pakistani government had announced nationwide lockdown, it lifted the precautionary restrictions on congregational prayers. The decision came 3 days after the cleric said that such limitations are not acceptable, and there were several incidents of clashes between police and worshippers. As congregations increase in size during Ramadan, doctors fear that government's this decision will shoot up the number of corona patients in the country, making it very difficult for the medical fraternity to save the people's lives.
हमारे हुकुमरान ने बहुत गलत फैसला किया है और हमारे उलमा ने बहुत गैर संजीदगी का और गैर इसका मुजाहरा किया है, इंसान की जान से खेलने का मुजाहरा किया गया है। हमें जिस तरह से उलमा हमें गाइड करते हैं इस्लाम के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से, ये लड़ाई कोरोना वर्सेस डॉक्टर्स पैरामेडिकल स्टाफ है, समझने की जरूरत है।
The doctors even marked out that a 20-point list of standard operating procedures for mosques agreed between the government and the religious leaders to hold the spread of coronavirus was not practical. In a statement distributed at the news conference, they called for the strict enforcement of lockdowns, urging businesses to bear with the hardships for a few more weeks until the virus could be brought under control.
वज़ीर आज़म साहब ने एक बात बहुत अच्छी की है कि जो SOPs पे पूरा नहीं उतरता उस मस्जिद को बंद कर देंगे। सर, वज़ीर आज़म साहब, जब तक बहुत देर हो चुकी होगी, जब आपको पता लगेगा कि एक हफ्ते के बाद, 10 दिन के बाद तो बहुत सारे लोग बिस्तर के लिए ढूंढ रहे होंगे, बहुत से लोगों को वेंटिलेटर की प्रॉब्लम हो रही होगी।
Pointing out at the availability of proper infrastructure, another doctor at the news conference said that with the rise in number of coronavirus cases, many patients in future can be denied admission due to dearth of beds.
जितनी COVID-19 की फैसिलिटीज़ हमारे पास इस वक्त शहर में, कोरोना के वायरस की जो सीरियस मरीजों की फैसिलिटीज़ इस वक्त शहर में, वो तकरीबन अपनी मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी पे ऑलरेडी आ गई हैं, जबकि अभी ये मर्ज ने पीक नहीं किया है, अभी हम जो ग्राफ के इस तरफ है, उल्टे हाथ पे।
The congregational prayers had already been the biggest worry and challenge for the authorities, and now as the Ramadan month had started and government has allowed the mosques to stay open, the country is surely going to witness the surge in number of cases. Pakistan, the world's second most populous Muslim country after Indonesia, has reported more than 10,000 cases of the coronavirus, including more than 210 deaths.
Moving on to Bangladesh, where some garment factories have switched to the manufacturing of personal protective equipments as they are shut down following the cancellation of orders amid coronavirus outbreak had rendered thousands of their employees jobless. The workers were sitting at homes with little food and money for past several days. Some of them had even taken to streets and had blocked highway, demanding their salaries. However, this is not the return of the vibrant industry, as only a section is working again and hundreds of thousands others are still sitting at their homes.
The sewing machines were humming in a factory in Dhaka as workers stitched together personal protective equipment suits for doctors, nurses, soldiers and police in the country. Some garment factories have resumed their work in capital, and this time it is not for the major apparel brands but for the protective gears that people involved in executing the essential services require during the pandemic. Celebrity Garment Exports is among the few factories that are making PPE at the moment amid a shortage in the country. The factory had previously been closed, but Managing Director Mohammad Sharif Ahmed said workers are producing suits for a government order. Other factories are selling them on the street to keep up with local demand.
মূলত আমরা এক্সপোর্ট করি বর্তমানে আমাদের দেশে চাহিদার কারণে করোনা ভাইরাসের পিপি বানানোর জন্য আমাদের প্রতিষ্ঠানটি খোলা রাখছি তাই আমরা সকাল 8টা থেকে বিকাল 5টা পর্যন্ত আমাদের দেশের র‍্যাব ডাক্তার নার্স র‍্যাব আর্মি পুলিশ বিডিআর এবং সাংবাদিক ভাইদেরকে এই করোনা ভাইরাসের পোশাক দেওয়ার জন্য আমরা আমাদের প্রতিষ্ঠান সকাল 8টা থেকে 5টা পর্যন্ত খোলা রাখছি
Bangladesh's crucial garment industry employs 4 million workers across some 4,000 factories. They all have become unemployed due to the lockdown and have been asking for salaries as they say they have no food for survival. Factory owners say their factories will remain open even after the medical demands are fulfilled and they will cater to normal public's demand after that.
আমাদের দেশে লকডাউন যদি খুলে যায় তাই আমাদের দেশের চাহিদা শেষ করে আমরা বাইরে এই করোনা ভাইরাসের পোশাক রপ্তানি করার জন্য চিন্তা ভাবনা করব.
As per the industry bodies, Bangladesh, the world's second largest apparel producer after China, is set to lose about $6 billion of export revenues this fiscal year as retailers and brands across the world cancel orders. Garment exports accounted for $34.1 billion or 84% of the country's overall exports in the fiscal year through June 2019. The number of cases is rising every day in China. There have been over 100 deaths linked to the new coronavirus and 4,000 cases in Bangladesh.
আচ্ছা মানে আমি গলা ব্যথা তো ডাক্তার দেখাবো তো করোনা টেস্ট ছাড়া তো ডাক্তার দেখানো যাবে না সেটা দেখানোর জন্য আসছি করোনা টেস্ট রিপোর্ট নেওয়ার জন্য
Bangladesh's government last month launched a $588 million package to help companies in the crucial garment sector pay staff during the pandemic. But manufacturers have said it is not enough.
As people in India stay at home to keep the novel coronavirus in check, The country's few creative minds are coming out with novel ways to create awareness about the pandemic and enforce nationwide lockdown. So today, let's take a look at few such examples whose creativity in the midst of corona is truly applausible.
मैं यमराज हूँ, मास्क लगाओ।
Dressed as the Hindu god of death Yamraj, an artist in New Delhi is roaming around the streets of the capital, warning people about the perils of going outside and ensuring citizens follow lockdown rules.
हाथों को धोते रहे और घर से बाहर कभी निकलने की चेष्टा ना करें।
People who queued up for food at Gandhinagar area of the city were asked to wear masks and sanitize their hands as the artist depicting the god of death kept reminding them to take proper precautions or else they will face death because of their carelessness. The motive behind doing this was to make people aware and instill fear in them about the impact of the fast spreading disease.
यमराज जो घूमता है उसका संदेश यही है कि या तो आप जो हमारे डॉक्टर्स कह रहे हैं हमारी गवर्नमेंट कह रही है उसके अनुसार चलिए उसका पालन कीजिए अगर आप नहीं करेंगे तो मैं आपको ले जाऊंगा।
Meanwhile, a red auto rickshaw with the spikes of coronavirus all over its structure, making announcements on a loudspeaker mounted on it, is catching eyeballs in Chennai city of Tamil Nadu. The coronavirus auto is creating awareness on the city roads against littering and speeding and its unintentional effect on coronavirus. Creator of the coronavirus auto, Gautam, has used colored bottles to make the spikes on the auto to look like the deadly virus which has killed more than 191,000 people worldwide and affected over 2.7 million.
People who are actually having the corona and they have a better immune means they actually spread the corona to the commuters by throwing and also by spitting on the public. So this thing has to be stopped. So just in order to tell this major point, I created by means of using the plastic bottles and waste materials. So the complete corona, what you are seeing, is made up of waste materials alone. Over, like as I said, 165 bottles are used.
Though the pandemic COVID-19 has taken the entire world in its grip and has created an atmosphere of fear all around, but the integrated efforts of the government and the citizens have shown that not only can its spread be contained, but a strong resolve followed by commitment can eliminate it entirely.
Even the law enforcement agencies have come up with several creative steps to stem the spread of the pandemic. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.